Hi everyone, just thought of sharing my simple pencil watercolor shading work. So I'm using my stamp set. This is a baby theme stamp set. So, and I'm using my Acaival ink pad for this. These are permanent ink pads. So you can use them with any of your project, be scrapbooking, mixed media, or anything, cause they do not smudge with water, color, anything. So these are like super to use. I'm just speeding up the process of the stamping so that we can finish it a little fast. So at a time, I usually prefer to do multiple stamping so that I have a whole page to color at a time, and this is such a big stress buster. I love it. And even my 5-year-old daughter Vanya, she also loves playing around when I do coloring, and she is always there for her suggestions and help me out with the color combinations. Yeah, so I'm done with the stamping. I'm just using it my baby wipes to clean the stamps. Make sure you clean them properly so that they last long. And I'm super happy to share that this is an Indian made stamps. Yeah. Okay, so now I'm going to use my Faber-Castell and Camel watercolor pencils. I love them. I love combining them because both of them has totally different color, look and feel. And you can even see the difference while working also. So I'll just speed up the process of coloring because, yeah, it's a stress buster thing and it takes a lot of time. So quick. So I'm just coloring the diapers of the babies now, and colorful ones. Yeah, and let's see how it looks. So after finishing my diapers, I'm just thinking of like coloring the body of 2-3 babies with the basic peach color set. So right now what I'm doing is I'm making it a neutral coloring. So I'm not going to highlight any body part or any shadow thing because I'm going to use them as cutout embellishments. Now I'm using my Koi water brush. These are awesome to work with. Awesome. So, and they blend in colors very, very well and super easy. Yeah. Okay. So this is how it looks. So I'm planning to color my second baby also a little darker shade. So I just use them on my different projects. The color depends on the what color theme I'm taking for my scrapbooks or the card or the explosion box what I'm making. So it completely depends. So a little speed up process again, and make sure you clean your water brush after using each color. Yes, that's a basic mistake what we do. We do not clean the brushes, and then the colors what we get is a little shady, darker, and it looks a little patchy. Make sure you clean your water brush every time you use a different color, and after your final coloring, clean your brushes properly. That's a must thing. Yeah, now third one. I'm just going to do the basic coloring. So I'm not sure. I'm so sorry for this bad light effect, but I'm trying different shades of peach for the body part just to have the varieties when I work on. Now, just to show the basic depth, or you can call it as a shadow part of the body. So in this, first I'm going to do the basic coloring, and then I'm going to highlight the shadow part of the body. So that is on the knees, hands, below the neck, nearby cheeks. So I'm just giving a little darker shade of the peach to highlight those areas, and then I'm going to smudge it with my water brush. See, it's super easy and it looks very cute, and these are ready for fussy cutting and to make your project awesome. I'm sure This will help you in some of the other way. If you like my video, do subscribe to my channel for such more tutorials. Thank you so much for watching.